Remember to hit that bell icon for instant notifications on fresh videos and brand new content.
Let me ask you guys a question, okay? How many of you here traveled in a matchbox? I have. Only thing is the name of the matchbox is Double Decker Express. Have you been to Double Decker Express? Have you traveled Double Decker Express? It's a train which goes from Chennai to Bangalore and back. Oh my God, that's one horrible piece of vehicle. You know, I'll tell you why, okay? For those of you who don't know what Double Decker Express is, there are two levels to the train, okay? It's not the ground floor and first floor, no. First floor and basement. So when you enter, you'll have to either go up or go down. Unfortunately, if you get a seat in the lower level, and if somebody has come to say Tata bye-bye to you, you will not be able to see them. You will be able to see only their legs. They'll have to do this. You will be thinking, oh, my dad has changed his shoes. That won't be your dad. Somebody would have stepped on a cow dung, will be shaking there. It's horrible. And you cannot see the trees on the way. You will be seeing only the roots. Entire route will be this route only. This is horrible. Yeah, text. And the seats are so uncomfortable, you know, so jam-packed, you can actually listen to what the other person is thinking. It's so jam-packed. Forget stretching your legs. There's no room for stretching your imagination also. If you drop a pen, you cannot directly bend it. You'll have to ask the next person to get up and go out of the compartment. Bend down and take. So moral of the story is, if you are traveling by double-decker express, do not drop anything. If you still want to drop the idea of dropping anything. See, I usually travel with my family, okay? Three of us will go, all three of us will be sitting together. It was kind of comfortable, but one day I had to travel alone. I was going from Chennai to Bangalore, morning 7:25 train. It reaches Bangalore at 1 o'clock. I reached the central station by around, 6:45. And I was walking towards the train. One guy came running behind me. Sir, bro, you are different level, bro. I'm like, thank you. I see your videos from morning to evening, every day. We are big fans, bro. What's your name, bro? See, from my childhood, I'm shameless, okay? This is fine. I'm like, my name is Praveen. Do you want a selfie? No, name is enough, sir, and he went. It's okay. So I went to the bookstall. Since I reached early, went to the bookstall, bought some thought-provoking books like Chanda Mama, Tinkle Digest, Times of India, okay? I bought everything and went inside the train, went to the upper level, opened the train ticket, and I was looking for my seat. One more guy came. Bro, you're different level, bro. I'm like, thank you, do you want a selfie? No, your seat is in the lower level. Full puppy shame happened. Okay. So after cleaning the cow dung, I went down to the lower level, looked for my seat, and finally found my seat. It was a middle seat, okay? It was a middle seat. I was carrying a small bag behind and a big bag in the front. So it was a middle seat. There was a huge guy sitting in the aisle seat. So I asked him to vacate the place and go to the next compartment so I can enter. So I went and sat. I'm like, it is comfortable only. Why is everybody saying bad about this? Then he sat. I was sitting like a touch me not plant. I was like, I was sitting like this. See, luckily for me, this guy, the window seat guy, was a thin guy, okay? But a crack. He was talking to himself. First, I thought he was telling something to me. I was like, what? Then he was talking to himself. Basically, he was playing dumb charades. He is only acting the movie and he is only finding it out. Okay. This is what he is doing. He was like, blook, 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 Titanic. Then he wiped his hand. It became wet, it seems. Method acting. Then he was like, fight? In the fight, there's a song. In the fight, Vivekam! You are only different level, bro. I'm like, okay, I was telling myself, only 5.5 hours, I'll be fine. Only 5.5 hours, I'll be fine. Then the train started moving. This breakfast sales guy came, okay? He was selling pongal and masala dosa. It was during Diwali time, so I didn't buy pongal. So I got I got masala dosa, okay? I like masala dosa, I was very, very hungry. So before I could take the first bite, I could feel one guy, one boy, okay, 4-year-old boy behind me kicking my seat. He was throwing tantrums. Why? He was hungry. What does he want? Dosa. Which dosa? My dosa. See, as a mother, what should she say? She should have said, no, no, that is uncle's dosa. I'll buy you a new one. No. That lady said, that dosa is full of germs. Only dirty people will eat it. I'm shameless, hungry. I kept on eating. He kept on kicking. It helped in digestion. Fine. Then this dollar pet came. Okay. Dollar pet came, lot of changes happened, except around me. Three people in the front, they left and three new people came. Three Marwadi ladies. Two old and one young. The one young lady was carrying a baby. And as soon as these people sat, within 5 minutes, the two old ladies took out their mobile phone, started watching Hindi mega serial in YouTube without headphone. All I could hear was, Battamis Bahu. Battamis Bahu. Buffering. I'm like, I don't understand Hindi. I'm like, what? This got stuck in my head. I wanted to divert myself. I don't know what to do. I thought, okay, let me find out what movie this guy is acting. And I turned, this guy went to Hindi movies. I'm like, shit, what the hell? That time, this fat guy went on his work mode. He took his phone and started talking so loud. So I heard his entire business plan. He was talking so loud, I took my phone, not even one kuchi. I'm like, how is he talking like this? Then I realized that guy is directly listening. No need of phone. Bloody damn loud. And what was he talking? He was talking about, pack this 300 kgs of powder to Delhi. 50 kgs about to export to Singapore. I'm like, oh, Pablo Escobar level, Narcos level, cocaine. It is carom board powder. Like, carom board powder, so much hype. I was like, chai, what the hell, I did this. So this elbow touched this guy. He was playing dumb charades. He was like, don't disturb, day naye. Day naye, you are only acting the movie. You are only finding it out. Still, you made two mistakes. Don't disturb, it seems. Finally, we reached Bangalore. As soon as I got down, I was looking like this comedian in a movie after a bomb blast, like full dark, shirts torn, and all the hair were. Okay, that didn't happen. Right?